One. Hi there, this is Shirish Kulkarni, the CEO and founder of Throat Consultech, focusing on growth of small and medium businesses, doing it for last 5 years. With this new concept of Hatke, we are looking at innovative ways that institutions, corporations, and various organizations are getting run in this currently so-called challenged or constrained environment of a virus outbreak. We have such a great personality in the form of available with us with Dr. Ashutosh Misal, who is heading the organization to create leaders, industry leaders, who is a director in D.Y. Patil Institute of Management Studies. We have great honors to have you, sir, with us. Over to you for quick introductions that you can have, Doctor.
Thank you. Thank you, Shirish. Thank you all. I'm Dr. Ashutosh Misal. I'm heading at present the Institute D.Y. Patil Institute of Management Studies, which is currently affiliated to Savitribai Phule Pune University. We have been running MBA courses since 2004. The institution established in that year, and we have 180 intake at present. And I'm very proud to say that DYPMS is one of the best institutes under SPPU, and we are ranked third under all the MBA institutes at the Pune University area.
Wonderful. So yes, great. I think that sets a very different tone to our discussion. Education. Do you see that education is somehow a challenge, or it is a boon that you see in the current situation where students are not able to reach the institute, right? So is the knowledge reaching them, or they are reaching knowledge? How is it happening now, Doctor?
Yes, in fact, I'm very proud to say that this coronavirus has not affected us at all. No doubt, students at their places, but then they went home somewhere on 16th of March, and then we waited around 10 days, almost 10 to 12 days for the comeback, but then unfortunately it couldn't happen. So what we did is we started just like a routine timetable. From 1st of April, we scheduled minimum in a day, and that went on till yesterday. We had first phase of 10 to 15th April. And then after that, we asked our faculty members that how many people still have to complete this syllabus. So we had arranged for other additional sessions. So yesterday happened to be the last day. I'll give them maybe in the meeting in the evening from all of them that do they still require lectures. And I must mention that first of all, DYPMS is again very famous for the academic culture which we maintain. Unlike other MBA institutes, we have got almost 90% attendance in the class, in all the classes, which is a rare thing in other MBA institutes. Mm-hmm. Whereas I have a record of 176 attendance out of 180 through these online classes. So that may be the record in itself. So I'm very happy that even the students are out of touch physically, but then they are sitting across Maharashtra and other places, hardly barring 1 or 2%, I would say, those who are very much at remote places where they have got a connectivity issue, but then still they are managing it.
Wonderful to hear that. I think it's a great degree of connection or attachment or extensibility that you have. But in this space, do you think that this has created a little bit of a wave of really impacting education in a very different way, where knowledge can reach faster in a more effective way with the digital forms that we are seeing?
Yes, it is going to be, because unless and until this thing happened, I think people were not knowing about it. When online education was not so much trained in a country like us, this coronavirus has definitely come out with a positive in the education field. Many people have never done any kind of such classes on online platforms, or they were not aware about Moodles and any kind of MOOCs. But then it has become, I would say, a blessing in disguise. All the teachers, all the directors, they have learned the software right from scratch. Even I have learned the day one when I started conducting the classes online. So that is a, I think that happens to be a positive thing which has happened in Indian education industry.
Right. And this disruption would definitely help reach out to the masses. I believe it will ease out the pressure that we have to attend the classes. Would it reach to the masses education in this way, where you know we are kind of having a natural force to make this happen?
Yes, this will, because if we see the today's generation, I think they are smarter than any one of us. This generation is one step ahead of even generation Z. Mm-hmm. I think these are called the generation Alpha, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
I may be slightly mistaken. Mm-hmm. But then this generation is one level ahead of generation Z, and those are very much techno-oriented. So the initial phases, whenever we started with these online sessions, the students were smarter enough than the faculty members, and they were probably guiding some of us that, sir, this particular app is not good. You can try the other one, which doesn't require any money to be paid. You know, you have another app which is free, which will run uninterruptedly. And then instead of Zoom, I tried Jitsi, then I tried the WebEx, then I tried some another software as well. But then Jitsi was one which I found it very much interesting. And I had a class of 3 hours without any interruption in between.
Wow. Wonderful, wonderful. Yeah. And how are the students taking it? They are kind of charged up. They are feeling like, okay, I can do it. I can sit down. I can leisurely, you know, have my piece of snacks or tea or whatever. And still, yes. is it helping them out?
Yes, definitely. First of all, we had a timetable set. So they were aware about what is going to happen on 15th of April, right on 1st of April. So apart from that, we had been giving them assignments just like it happens in the class. For that purpose, I use Google Classroom. It's one of the effective software for getting the assignments done. It maintains all its record. It maintains who has submitted late. It has a facility of resubmitting. It has facility of grading, rubric, and many other things are there, which probably we cannot do in a physical contact class. Mm-hmm. Physical contact classes. So this software has really helped me. So students were also really enthusiastic to use this kind of a new technology. Mm-hmm. So they are more enthusiastic attending and as well as using this technology much better than attending classes.
Wonderful. Do you see the your peers or the professors or the teachers, so sharpening their acts to really make sure that they build on their own skill sets or something like that?
Yes. Because as I said right at the start, that even it was totally new to many of the faculties, including me. So we have to keep ourselves updated. So initially, people were not knowing how to mute their voice and how to shut off their video and start it again. So we started from there. So I started from scratch, and now they are all well versed. So that's not an issue.
So maybe a question like, how are you really keeping yourself motivated in this kind of, and what is the kind of message that you have in this?
Okay. I think it's never an end. So things are likely to come up. Rather, I would call this as a disruptive things happening. So education industry is definitely likely to come up with something positive. What is needed probably is all those who are into the education industry by their choice. Mm. They are the ones who are supposed to focus more. I would like to give an example from Bhagavad Gita, which speaks a lot about management. I'm very fortunate to have perceived a book on this. So one of the verses in Bhagavad Gita says that Vyavasayatmika Buddhirekha Kurunandan, means you have to focus only on your object, and then there you will definitely be succeeding in your endeavor. So I think that message all the teaching fraternity should take up, and they should move ahead. The future is theirs.
Good. I think, Doctor, it was wonderful and a very, very positive dimension that you showed about how education is driving itself digitally well in the current context, and also it will come out as ease of use or ease as you consume in the new context. So thanks a lot, Dr. Ashutosh, for spending your time.
Thank you, Shirish. Nice connecting.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
All the best.
Bye-bye.